Yo,
let's go,
David. Third concert together.
Let's go.
Usually the other way around. I'm usually there.
I'm tired today, but we're still gonna get it.
Yeah,
we're still gonna get it.
Who are we seeing tonight?
We are seeing Jesus Peace, Sangwa Sugabog, Peeling Flesh, and Gag.
Awesome. Have you seen all those bands before? Have you seen any of those bands before?
Nope, just me and you saw Peeling Flesh in November.
That's
for,
right,
for the Suicide Show.
And Chelsea Grin, yeah. November 9th.
Yep, and we are going back.
Yeah.
It's going to be a good time.
Yeah.
No, I'm not from around here, Clayton. I'm from down here in Calgary, so everything's
okay.
Going to be up here.
Cool.
I live in the old town, Wardy.
Yeah, I drive through there a lot because I go to Graham.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's where I stay.
Yeah, that's a cool view.
Mm-hmm.
I'm taking Liquid A too, but I can't do it.
I love this album.
Yeah, this part's great.
Have you heard this?
No.
Okay.
I've not.
Boys, it's actually really good. Like we did for Suicide Silence, because there is going to probably be stage diving,
mm-hmm.
but in that little corner, nobody was getting close to it, you know?
So like on the left-hand side there?
Yeah, okay. That was my goal. Because where we were last time, dude, I got bopped in the head.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, I had to quickly dart out of the way, and then I heard the thud of some people.
Yeah.
It wasn't until the last band, I was like, dude, no one's catching these people.
Yeah, no, I know.
Yeah, it was like, I wanted to crowd surf, and I was like, no, I don't.
No one was catching them, bro.
Yeah.
Even Matt Honeycutt from Kublai Khan in your video or one of the videos was like, oh, I heard that. We all heard that.
Yeah.
Pick them up.
Oh, gosh, yeah.
And it was when the music was playing, so you know that was a big thud.
Yeah.
There was 775,000 people in this place for the NFL draft this year.
Wow.
Did they throw the draft down psycho? The attendance was 775,000.
Budweiser frequency. Sorry, boys, we're going. My son giving you all the good angles today, bro.
Oh, yeah. That's definitely an advantage to seeing in the past when you see it.
I know, right?
Yeah.
Or a sweatshirt, because carrying it all around blows. I did that when we went in last time. We went straight to the merch.
Bring my bag. I'm throwing the bag.
You can't bring your bag in.
No bag. No, no, this.
Hey. Yeah, it's a Jordan. It's an experience, brother. Thank you. I think their second album is the best album. Drove to one of the shows in the truck, he doesn't give a shit. All he cares is that the one. He's a millionaire, you know what I'm saying? All he cares is I help him make his money.
Yeah.
But Shadow deserves a good
30 and 6 o'clock. The mechanics, everybody, all have the rest of it.
You Orton boys have no idea.
So mean them cowboys do that.
Oh yeah. Oh well, dude, you're up there more than me.
I just think it's kind of funny because.
You pause closer to Tom Rainier in the morning.
Right on.
I went to 61 shows last year.
61.
And tonight's my 27th show of this year.
Do you have like a goal of where you like a
thousand? No. Although there was a girl who I was interested in earlier this year who joked like, oh, maybe you should go to 80 shows. And I was like, no way. But I might. I mean, I'm sort of on track to go to that many shows this year. I think like cause I'm making concert vlogs and stuff, and I don't know, I make videos where I want people to, you know, like experience a show like through a video like the best they can.
Yeah. 5-inch TV, and then I see like it goes new to you and it's one of your videos, and I watch it and I look down to recent videos, and then there's all these videos that you post, and I just go down the rabbit hole.
Wow, thanks. I do the same thing too, though. Even though I've already been there, I get to relive it.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, you took the time.
It really took taped it off the Rainier Factory.
Wait, what happened with it?
That's incredible. Why are they?
It's her safe
haven.
She's
probably really lonely right now.
They get along. They have their own little thing. Like they'll go get fries together or something. Or he'll take her to go get an Emerald City smoothie. Or they do their thing.
Bet you Cora's playing the drums right now.
I bet you she wanted to come to this show, but I was like, there ain't no fucking way, dude.
There ain't no way. The last time I was in Seattle, it said Safeco.
So it's been like 10 years for you, huh? It's been like 10 years for you, huh? It's
been a while. Well, I'm surprised Seattle's this light on Sunday.
Oh, I knew it would be.
Driving on the freeway.
And now you're just like, whatever, like this, just drive.
Now I drive to Canada.
Yeah. Just
to get Slurpees.
What?
Oh, Eric, my friend Eric.
He drove to Canada one time because he always goes, Canada's Slurpees are different than America's and they're twice as good. So he drove to Canada with a cooler, filled the cooler up with Slurpees, and the Canadian Customs was like, what are you doing with that?
Oh my gosh.
And he opened it and they were like, are you serious? And he was like, yep. They opened up a cooler full. Yeah, they laughed, bro.
He literally bought fucking
a cooler
full of Slurpees.
Like a Yeti cooler.
Oh, dude, those.
Yeah, I think we turn right up here.
Right here?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right.
I'm already lost.
Yeah. Well, here's a classic example for you, gentlemen. You see those windows up there?
Yeah.
Those windows are so fucking old. There's probably not. There's probably water through them and mold underneath all that. It's disgusting.
That dude came in.
What's that say? Beer inside.
See, like, look at that building. Like,
there's so many windows per spacing. Like, it makes me go,
how do they engineer that structure? I still feel like when I come into Seattle, I come into a new whole part of the world. Every time. There's some fucking views for you,
that dude passed out. He's pissed off on you.
Probably.
Oh yeah, here we go. It begins, boys.
I think I've seen that before. I didn't know that was. Do you think it's part of it though? I think it's just right. Is that?
I don't think.
It'd be weird if it wasn't a part of it, but I think it. I think it's. It's not. It looks like it's a different property.
That's not bad at all. Oh no, nah, dude. We park here all the time. It's cute.
Yeah.
That shit's fucking. Yeah. What spot is that? 3. Hey, later tonight, can you take a picture of Jordan and I on my phone?
Yeah.
My mom would want to take pictures. Mom, sure.
I've watched these guys build this building. I puked on security guard here.
Hey, Kyle. away if you want to, bro. Yes.
Thank you. but times 100. Peeling Flesh, Sengui Sugabog, and Jesus Christ Wrestling play the best sets of their entire fucking band career. So pull up and make it happen.
This song's called Walmart Reality.
Yeah. This next song is about war. And how fucked it is. And how the only purpose of it is money, power. And what the cost is our lives, their lives. How is a life worth any money? It's so fucked.
We are on tour with Peeling Flesh. Sandwich you the ball for Jesus peace. There's a new song called Fine China.
I just want to say Free Palestine.
Felons and baristas.
Free Palestine!
No one makes it out alive. Blood on the dance floor.
Fortnite, bitch! Not the Fortnite, bitch! Big ups to Peeling Fucking Flesh. And last but not least, big ups to Sandwich Sugar Bob. Set this one off for me, huh?
I'm sorry, man.
This next one's a fast one. I want to see a circle play. Oh,
I get to be in the legendary venue. The outdoor is on. Thank you to them. Thank you to y'all. That was sold out gig. Appreciate you. Let's set this motherfucker up. out here and share these moments with a bunch of people that I don't know. But we find this common interest. It gives me purpose in this world, so thank you for that. This next song I wrote about being afraid of letting the people down around me. Not put my shit on the line. Not gambling. To make a better life for myself. If you feel that shit, this is for you. Fear of failure. We'll be right back.
Long walks on the beach, short walks to the refrigerator, and he likes to kill people. That's what he likes to do. This song's about his life. It's called Feeding for Bloodshed.
Let's go. phone.
You guys want to hear one more? Make some noise. And you guys want to hear two more? Make some even bigger noise. This song's called Mortal Admonishment.
With us or what?
Alright, let's fuck it up. If you haven't got on this goddamn stage, I advise you to do so. This song's called Dead as Shit.
with the dance party going on.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, one more down. And there was a kid that stage drove off of it.
Oh my gosh.
And I got a pic, his face, dude. He was just cheesing from ear to ear. And I just saw his face and I turned the camera on and I was like, that right there is a happy fucking smile.
Have a good night.
Good night, man.
Yeah, you too.
Thank you.
Yeah, but I decided earlier that my favorite venue I've ever been to is Funhouse.
Is the Funhouse?
Yeah. I mean, El Corazon is great, but like, just like the significance for me, because like, my first concert.
That's where it all began?
It wasn't like the first concert, but it's like the first one where after that it started becoming more like habitual. That was at Funhouse.
Dude, I'm telling you, as you keep getting older, you keep doing this, you're just gonna keep getting more worn out.
Oh my gosh.
And then you know what you do? You really start investing into like nice cameras and video cameras, and you become your own like photographer, videographer. You get on the stage with the passes.
And then I think someone put their hands up thinking it was theirs, and he throws it in the crowd. One of them could have been a homie to one of the people, it could have been a coworker, Del Corazon, I don't know. But the dude comes out five minutes later, he goes, "Where's my sweatshirt?"
One of the workers.
The girl behind me piped on her phone, "Someone threw your sweatshirt in the crowd." And I was like, "Keys were in there." And that was it.
That's what you were. You told me you had that about your keys. You're like, so put it in your pocket or something.
Yeah, because that guy was literally jumped in the crowd and just started looking for his keys.
I'm pretty sure. Oh my gosh. And someone dropped their glasses or
two. Dude, people were losing shit left and right, bro.
I felt bad.
Dude, this guy, he's gonna break in the fucking store. This is drive back to Woods.
I think honestly that's a smart move. Huh? Oh, head back tonight. Right, your adrenaline's still going.
Are you talking to me?
Yeah. No, I said I think that's actually a smart move. Concert vlog video. Hey, that's where my job site's at. You see that right in front of it.
All lit up?
Well, not that, but the building in front of it.
Oh.